It's an honor to be here. It's an honor to take part in one of these Fusion events. And these Fusion events, to me, are all about teamwork. So we can't kick off day two without our own team. And so let me introduce Fast Company's Editor-in-Chief, Stephanie Mehta, with a special announcement.
Thank you, General Wilson. I'm so happy to be here today with this incredible AFWERX team that you had a hand in cultivating. For those of you who don't know, Fast Company is the world's leading media business publisher focusing on innovation, technology, leadership, world-changing ideas, creativity, and design. We celebrate organizations and companies that foster innovative thinking by investing in technology, research and development, and most of all, in their employees. For the second year, in collaboration with Accenture, the leading global professional services company, Fast Company has ranked the top workplaces for innovators from around the world. I'm honored to share that Fast Company has named AFWERX number 16 on the 100 best workplaces for innovators for 2020. So congratulations to all of you. Dr. Brian Beam Mao, you are one of the founders of AFWERX with General Wilson. Can you talk a little bit about what this award means to you?
Well, thank you for that great question, Stephanie, and we hope you are enjoying Fusion today. This award means something special to us in two very distinct ways. One is our commitment to the individual, and the other is the AFWERX commitment to national defense. Individually, we believe that anyone can change the future because an innovation can start with just a single person's idea, and AFWERX then seeks to help them create an alternate reality. At the national defense level, our national defense strategy actually says that we're supposed to integrate insights from business innovation. So what a serendipitous day that today, during a Fusion event, we get to celebrate with you, Stephanie, the fusion of some incredible individuals who are empowered to create a stronger, more innovative national defense for our democracy. We thank our visionary leaders, General Wilson, Lieutenant General Harris, Senior Executive Jack Blackhurst from the Air Force Research Lab, as well as our incredibly talented business partners from The Difference, such as Brandon and Mark Rowland from Rocketeer Inc. All of them have boosted us to this world-class level. AFWERX has a three-word credo, Stephanie. It is to empower, innovate, and defend. And so this award, ma'am, means that we are practicing what we preach. Thanks again, and back to you.
Oh, well, thank you, Dr. Mao. You mentioned Brandon and the work that The Difference has done. Brandon, your team has been part of that private sector side of AFWERX and the collaboration. Can you share your thoughts on this award?
I'd love to, but before we talk about the award and the amazing team, being mentioned a few of them, I want to pause for a second and take a step back. So this here is a picture of my grandpa in World War II with his crew. And it struck me literally this morning when I looked at this picture, and it says most airplanes you've probably seen have the insignia that's like mildly inappropriate on the airplanes. And my grandpa had Ken's men on his. And I never really understood what that meant. He explained it to me several times. I didn't really understand it. And then I was thinking back to a couple of years ago when a lot of people don't know this, but it wasn't just known as AFWERX back in the day. General Harris, some of the other, General Wilson, others, just kind of casually referred to it as Beam's team. And I was like, Beam's team, Ken's men. Beam always introduces us to your diverse talent with common minds. And he has this spirit in him that leads not just in innovation in a command and control way, but in a spirit of service. And I finally got it. My grandpa always talked about service. He never talked about innovation. He went on to 3M and helped develop the Post-it note, for crying out loud. He talked about service, not innovation. And I think back to the success of AFWERX over the last couple of years, and Beam, you lead us with a service standpoint that is, you know, doesn't exist in so many leaders out there. And that's what's truly driven the innovation. I also know that as AFWERX has grown, I think Colonel Diller's on the phone here, General Pringle, Dr. Roper, everybody here that's been so supportive in helping lead this team. And of course, our team, I don't know, I think it's over 100 on this Zoom call right now, but so many people that have helped out. I can't possibly name everybody, but it's really amazing. And so before, Stephanie, I turn it back over to you and thank Beam again and our whole team for our innovation and our service. It's truly an honor to the country. My uncle drove this over to me this morning. So Beam, I think our first challenge together was reinventing the helmet for our pilots, serving our country and innovating along the way. So my uncle dropped off my grandpa's World War II helmet that he fought the last battle over Tokyo with and earned the Distinguished Flying Cross in. So I'm going to put it on you, on me for you today and the whole team. I'm not going to breathe whatever was in this mask. But so Beam, Stephanie, Colonel Diller, generals, thank you so much. It's an honor to be part of the private sector and truly serve and help our country innovate and serve in a totally different way than my grandpa did, but gall darn it, are we proud of it. So thank you so much. Stephanie, back to you.
Thank you so much, Brandon. You know, one of the things that struck us at Fast Company about the AFWERX application to be recognized as one of the best workplaces for innovators was how AFWERX encourages people at all levels to contribute. And so if it's okay with you, I'd like to hear from one of your airmen, perhaps someone who's a little bit earlier in their career who might have wondered if their voice would be heard as a junior member of the service. I believe Staff Sergeant Jordan Fetter is available to share some insights on how long you've been with the team and what it's like to work for AFWERX.
Yes, Stephanie, thank you so much. This is so exciting, and it's reminded me a lot of the progress that I've been part of here at AFWERX. And a bit about myself, I joined back in 2014, and when I first joined, I was the type of person who questioned the status quo and was always looking for new ways to do things and innovate. But I've met a lot of resistance from peers and supervisors in the traditional Air Force side who just didn't believe that change was possible and didn't really believe that we were going to have an impact at the level that I was at. And then it wasn't until a couple of years ago when I joined AFWERX that I started to see changes happening across the service through Spark Cells and throughout like various communities that I'm part of. And I started to realize that I could take the frustration that I had when I first joined the Air Force and actually put it to good use and start changing the Air Force for the better. And I've now seen that the power that we have to impact the culture within the service, as well as teach leaders how to help their people feel heard and valued, and even go so far as to shape the direction of like U.S. innovation as a whole, which is something that has been really cool to see happen at AFWERX. So it's been a really incredible experience, and I can't wait to see where we go next. And this has been really awesome. And thank you and Fast Company for recognizing us.
Great. Thank you, Jordan. I would love to hear from everyone who has come together to make this happen, but unfortunately, we don't have the time. Once again, congratulations to everyone on the AFWERX team, both on the government as well as the private sector side. You should all be super proud of what you've created here. Thank you again for having me.
Wonderful, Stephanie. Thank you so very much. Dear diverse talent within our common mind, this is a moment of history that we would like to capture for just a few seconds. Would everybody please video screen up so we can take a couple of quick screen captures?
AFWERX team, both on the government.
Very good, very good. Some raised hands in cheer. 1, 2, 3. Huzzah to AFWERX. Well done, everybody. Diverse talent once again. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Pictures taken, awesome. And I know there's a lot of time.
Congrats, team. You know, again, as we talked about Fusion events, it's all about empowerment. And let's look at what we've done over the last 3 years. Sure, we've made lots of tactical things. We've gone from zero to now over 80 Spark Cells. We've gone from zero to over 4,500 submission on idea scale. But it hasn't just been tactical things. You also have done some big strategic things. Space, ISR, mobility, and this year, Base of the Future. And these Fusion events get better every year. You know, 3 years ago, we looked at perimeter security, and we had over 60 exhibitors come to that event. In 2019, we did joint all-domain C2. We doubled the number of exhibitors. Over 100 came to that. And this year, for the Base of the Future, we had 1,600 submissions, of which we picked 350 exhibitors to come here today. And I contend we're just getting started, so strap in. Now, if you look around the world today at all the challenges we face, we got plenty of challenges. But I'm also going to contend those challenges are opportunities. It's opportunities for us to change and flip the script. We don't just want your help, we need your help. help us win, build the Air Force we need for tomorrow. And these are great events. I hope you're having lots of fun. Yesterday, we looked at base defense and installation resilience. So how do we build that digital base of the future? Today, we're going to look at AI and additive manufacturing and how we can make, again, that base of the future possible. Tomorrow is all about the most important weapon system we have, our airmen and their families. Thank you all for being here, for supporting this. I can't wait to see what you make possible.